So the keynote is about happiness. We're going to teach your people how to use happiness as a tool to succeed generally and to succeed in life. And the way we're going to deliver the keynote is in a really laugh out loud, funny way. And you notice I said laugh out loud, funny. I don't mean a chuckle or a chortle. I don't mean a tee-hee. I mean, we want them laughing for a couple reasons. One, it's fun, right? You know, crying out loud, your people crave it. But the second reason is because if we hang this really meaty message on a framework of humor and entertainment, it really makes the message memorable, it makes the message portable, and it makes it sticky. It sticks with them so that when they get back to work, they still remember it. People tend to learn more when they're laughing, so we want them laughing. But we don't just want them to laugh, we also want to give them some value, right? In the end, if we don't create some sort of behavior change, it's a fail. So that means while they're laughing and while they're ready for this message, and believe me, while they're laughing, they are ready, we're going to deliver a completely consistent message with that laughter, which is happiness. We're going to talk to them about how happiness has a really strong business value, how happiness makes us better as people, it makes us better at home, and happily and amazingly, happiness makes us better at work. So we're going to show them and get them to buy into why happiness is so important. And we're going to show them that happiness is something that is achievable and not nearly as hard as they thought, or as they thought. And then best of all, we're going to give them ideas. We're going to show them how to be happier. By the end of the keynote, they will have some specific ideas about how to be happier starting right then. So it's really funny. I think that entertainment component is easy to gloss over, but it's important. We want to do everything we can to shake up that audience to create a business message, but deliver it in a way that's unlike any business program they've ever seen. You know, that's why we use music, we use audience participation, there's confetti, there's PowerPoint that is different from anything you've ever seen before. It's on purpose, because we want, you know, every few seconds for them to jar themselves awake so they're really available and ready for that message, which again is, you can be happier, it's important to be happier, here's how to be happier. Now do it, because it makes you better, it makes your organization better, it makes everything better. Happiness is not emotion, happiness is an attitude and something you can learn. It's not as hard as you think. It's not as fuzzy as you think. There are specific techniques and skills that anyone can learn and adopt immediately that will make you happier. And this is a magical thing, because it not only feels good, I mean, let's face it, who doesn't want to be more happy? But not only does it feel good, it has a value. It has a business value. Individuals and organizations who are happy tend to produce more, to create more, to innovate more. So it's the coolest thing. That means if you are happier, you're a better leader. If you are happy, you're a better manager. You collaborate better, you innovate more, you're more healthy, which saves on healthcare costs. Happiness has a measurable business value. So that's my job. My job is to come in and work with organizations and teams of all different sizes and help them with these specific skills about how to be happier as individuals, how to be happier in their home lives, and specifically how to be happier with all of the amazing things they're doing with their job. I mean, let's face it, you spend so many of your hours at work. Doesn't it make sense to invest at least a little bit of your time figuring out how to make that time not only productive, not only successful, but happier? Yeah, it does. And here's the other cool thing about that. We tend to think that if we do well at work or whatever, we do well at any given project or task, that will make us happy. But the magical thing is that we've got it flip-flopped, we've got it wrong. What social scientists and academics are telling us is that if we are happy, we're better, we're more successful. If we are happy, success follows, rather than if we are successful, happiness follows. No, if we are happy, we are able to achieve. So happiness has a completely measurable business value. The choice really then is, what are you willing to do to make yourself happy and your organization happy? And are you willing to take the steps necessary? They're these simple, easy to implement steps necessary to start happiness now.